The Earth is a flat plane like this. The cosmologies teach us that there's a mountain in the center in the North Pole called Magnetic Mountain or Mount Meru. This is a magnetic mountain, and the color of this is blue. It is lapis blue. So it blends in with the sky, and so it's the same color, and so this cannot be seen. And the sun, what the sun is doing, at the Tropic of Cancer, the sun does circles high up in the sky, and at the Tropic of Capricorn, its circles are much lower and closer to the Earth, and this will be the center line, what we call the equator. And so what we have is the sun is now here on the 21st of December at the Tropic of Capricorn, closer to the Earth, much, much closer to the Earth at the Tropic of Capricorn. And what it does is it climbs up on an incline as it goes up to the Tropic of Cancer every year. So for 6 months, it's waxing.
Yeah.
And then for 6 months, it's waning. These circles that the sun does, these are all 24-hour circles. So you see, we have a variable speed sun. Obviously, the sun is slower here at the Tropic of Cancer and much faster at the Tropic of Capricorn.
Yeah, to get around that distance.
This is what the flat Earth projection looks like, the plan. This is the sun and the moon in their circles above the Earth. So that's what planet means. It means plane. You can't go to Mars. Now, these people who think they've gone to Mars, they've gone somewhere, yes. But they haven't gone to Mars because you can't go to Mars as a physical body, not these bodies. You know, whereas some people would just jump off and say, oh, this is all nonsense, and rather they would rather subscribe to the consensus reality model of the globe because everybody else believes it. And without any proofs or evidences, it's simply ridiculous. It is the axis point. In fact, Polaris is directly above Brahma's locale, you could call it, or loka, which is above that mountain in the center of the North Pole. Here are some of the scriptures which really point to a flat Earth. So here we've got the city of Brahma just above the central magnetic mountain in a dome-like structure. I don't believe it's like a physical dome. I think it's a luminous dome. When you study and research this subject, you'll find that on the one hand, there is no evidence, no facts, no proofs, and no truths. And on the other side, weighing in favor of the flat Earth, there is only evidence, only proof, only facts, and only truths.
Santos has posted to Facebook and is calling people worshippers of demons, basically, for following the, for not believing in the flat Earth model. He's just gone crazy. He says other crazy stuff in this post. I met Santos twice in 2012 in person. We spent some time together. I certainly enjoyed Santos's company, but this is just crazy stuff from Santos. When you look at international flights, in particular from New Zealand to Houston, Texas, and if you look to flights from, say, New Zealand or Australia across to Argentina, to Buenos Aires and all the rest of it, and you look at the times, it all doesn't match up. It's just ridiculous. If you look at the star trails, in particular, taken on the equator at Ecuador, on the equator, you can see the evenness there. It's like sort of being in a tunnel in a way, and none of that stuff matches up with these stupid flat Earth models. So just crazy, Santos. Ridiculous.